Good afternoon. I'm Marilyn Elder, and this is Bobcat Update. Today, we will take a look at an unexpected find on a local construction site.
And later on in the show, we'll take a look at some amazing footage that was shot during the tornado in Dallas. If you're looking to enjoy an ice-cold drink on the San Marcos River, you've got just under a month to do so. City Council's vote on whether or not to ban alcohol in city parks has been postponed until May 1st. The vote was initially scheduled for Tuesday night's council meeting, but after the absence of one of its members, a vote was taken to push the date back. If passed, the ban would not only prohibit alcohol in city parks, but also on bridges and dams crossing the San Marcos River.
A Hays County jury on Monday watched a tape of a Buda murder suspect confessing to the crime. David Simmons is on trial for the murder of Stephen Wolfel over 2 years ago. Wolfel had been dead a week before his body was discovered burning at his home. Simmons was arrested in Missouri in 2010. The San Marcos Daily Record reported that Simmons was transported back to the Hays County for the trial, where he has been representing himself. The trial is expected to go through next week.
Wednesday will be sentencing day for five former New Orleans police officers. They were convicted over the summer of shooting six unarmed civilians on the Danziger Bridge after Hurricane Katrina. Two of those people died. The officers fired upon a group walking across the bridge looking for a safe haven. Prosecutors allege there was a cover-up after the shootings, which included false reports and made-up witnesses.
Police say the suspect in a shooting rampage at a small religious college in California is revealing more about a possible motive in the case. Seven people were killed and three others were injured in the Oy Coast University shooting. The suspect is Won Go, a 43-year-old Korean native who had been expelled from the school. Police say Go had expressed dissatisfaction with the school for allegedly treating him unfairly. Go, an Oakland resident, had been a nursing student at the school.
Texas State has embraced the concept of e-learning. Lori Gonzalez explains in this Bobcat Update.
To date, Texas State has offered more than 200 online courses and continues to expand its distance learning courses. Lori Fennell, the university's distance learning assistant director, says online courses offer students more flexibility in scheduling. Fennell says the courses enable students who are geographically distant to take Texas State courses.
Students' lives are very complicated, and I think that's easy for us to forget that and try to force education to fit a 9-to-5, and it doesn't fit that.
For students who commute, online learning will save time and money.
You can do it in the comfort of your own home, especially for us commuter students who are either living in Austin or San Antonio, or for my case, Bernie.
Online classes prove to be useful in alleviating the need for classroom space on campus.
It would make traffic a lot easier, probably be less populated. It wouldn't take as long to get food, which would be nice as well. And I feel like everyone would be like just a little happier, not having to come to classes that they don't really want to come to, when they can just do it at their own house, you know what I mean?
There are many advantages to taking online classes, such as you can take them anywhere and anytime, making it possible to study when and where you want. For Bobcat Update, I'm Laura Gonzalez.
ASG voting ends at 5 o'clock this afternoon. It started yesterday at various locations on campus. You can vote in person at any of the booths located in the quad or in the LBJ Paseo. You can also vote online at the Texas State website. Winners will be announced today at 7 o'clock on the fourth floor of the LBJ Student Center.
Students who are planning to register for summer classes have until 11:59 tomorrow night. Classes for both summer 1 and 2 are open. To register, go to CatsWeb, select Student, then log on to the self-service page. From there, choose Student and select Registration and pick the classes you want. A list of classes and their times are available. Late registration for summer 1 opens May 29th and closes May 31st at 3. For summer 2, the dates are in early July.
An old cornerstone was discovered by construction workers at the new Candlewood Suites Hotel site in San Marcos. The date on the cornerstone is from 1910 and is believed to be from the old high school that was on the corner of Comanche and Hutchinson Street. Etched onto the stone are the names of former school board members, aldermen, and the 1910 mayor, J.R. Porter. The question of who owns the stone is still unsure, but for now it will remain in the hands of the hotel owner.
A Texas State organization is certainly taking this year's Common Experience First Amendment theme to heart. The Women and Gender Research Collaborative is encouraging students to faculty to speak out about gender issues. Catherine Kreider has more in this Bobcat Update.
taking a cue from the Occupy movements, the collaborative met Friday for a symposium to spread awareness of women's issues and to challenge the biases against women and other social minorities.
When we talk about women's issues, we're getting women's voices heard. So let's occupy free speech, because we have the right to be heard.
Women from Texas, Washington, D.C., Canada, and India spoke on topics ranging from the plight of disabled women in India, to the media's image manipulation of female architects, to the relative silence regarding intimate partner violence and HIV or AIDS. Dr. Carolyn Byerly spoke about the media's coverage of women's issues through time and what she sees as the need to increase feminist media activism. Dr. Byerly says a broader discussion of assault, incest, and other violence against women is needed.
I think the kind of symposium that we've got going on today are just incredibly important to put a focus, to put a spotlight on gender issues, because they can sometimes get lost.
Dr. Byerly and her colleagues at Howard University are advocating for an increase in feminist media activism. For Bobcat Update, I'm Katherine Kreider.
Students leaving San Marcos for the summer may be stuck paying rent on remaining apartment leases. Most apartments in San Marcos do not assist students in their subletting their rooms. Students of some apartments can pay a small fee to transfer their leases. Apartment locating services are available to help find summer residents. Students might find some luck posting ads on bulletin boards or creating ads on Craigslist.
Renting an apartment, as many students do, means taking responsibility. Renters have to make sure they pay their bills on time and keep food in the pantry. But part of the responsibility, one they don't often consider, is just staying out of harm's way.
Living in a college town, it's important to keep track of those who live around you. Be observant and take note of activities out of the norm. San Marcos resident Chelsea Surley says she once witnessed an attempted burglary take place.
I was coming down the stairs and I saw this guy trying to break into an apartment, and I knew that there was all girls that lived there. And luckily I live with three guys in my apartment complex, and I immediately woke up two of them that were closest to the door of our apartment, and one of them went out to make sure that I was really seeing what I was seeing.
The cops arrested the suspect and no one was harmed, but cases like this should be a reminder of the importance of apartment safety. Texas State student Kate Stevens says do simple things because they can make a difference.
I always have pepper spray just for extra safety, especially since I walk my dog in the middle of the night sometimes. I like to make sure that I have that just in case someone tries to get me.
Residents should also be aware of their apartment's balcony door, always making sure it's locked or having the safety bar down. Also, keep all valuables out of sight to avoid tempting the prowlers.
Just be aware of your surroundings. Know who's supposed to be there, who's not supposed to be there.
If you live on the first floor of an apartment complex, your windows and doors can be a prime target for thieves. One of the cheapest and easiest ways to protect your apartment is to buy one of these little sliding window locks, which you can find at any local hardware store. For Bobcat Update, I'm Lauren Landman.
It's a gorgeous day in San Marcos, but part of Texas had severe tornadoes to deal with yesterday. We'll have more on that later.
It's about 81 degrees out there right now. Tonight, the low will drop to about 57. If you're watching Bobcat Update, stay with us.
San Marcos is the perfect place for those who enjoy the outdoors, but Mother Nature can be harsh and uninviting. Deer and other creatures can thrive in these parts, but humans have different standards. For us, nature is about recreation, not survival. So it's important to have a path, but these paths don't clear themselves. They're a result of hours of hard work. And who does that work? Volunteers from the San Marcos Greenbelt Alliance. They wake up at sunrise and get straight to work. That way, when you want to enjoy the great outdoors, you have some place to go. Whether you're hiking, biking, or just looking to reconnect with nature, you can be assured that the trails are marked and cleared. The trails are ready. Are you? Visit their website at smgreenbelt.org and learn more about how you can help clear the trails and make nature more accessible to San Marcos.
It's been an exciting week for sports fans.
Mason Robinson has more in our Bobcat Sports Report.
Hi there, I'm Mason Robinson. Kentucky Wildcat fans are basking in the glory of their winning basketball team. The Wildcats defeated Kansas 67-59 Monday night in New Orleans to win their eighth NCAA championship. Yesterday, fans gathered at Rupp Arena in Lexington to rally in support of the champs. Fans began camping out at the arena minutes after the game ended to be in line when tickets for the rally were distributed yesterday. The Wildcats finished the season 38-2, the best record ever for a men's team. Baylor became the first NCAA basketball team, women or men, to complete a 40-0 season by defeating Notre Dame 80-61 in the NCAA Women's Championship on Tuesday. Paced by 6'8" junior center Brittany Griner, the National Player of the Year, the Lady Bears became the seventh undefeated women's champion. Griner hit her first seven shots of the second half and finished with 26 points, 13 rebounds, and 5 blocks. Baylor went wire to wire as the number one team and the overall top seed in the tournament. The Fighting Irish at 35-4 were the overall second seed. The San Antonio Spurs stretched their win streak to 8 games last night against the Cleveland Cavaliers. Tony Parker led San Antonio on a 16-0 run late in the first. Parker crosses over here and gets to the rim to give San Antonio the lead. Moments later, Parker works through the lane and finishes with the layup and the foul. He'd finish with 19 points. Danny Green also had a big night with 19 points in the second. Green knocks down a three from the corner, then another, putting the Spurs up by 18 in the second. In the third, more Parker. As he leads the break, dishes to Green, who lays it in. The Spurs get the win in that one, 25-90. The Masters Golf Tournament starts tomorrow in Augusta, Georgia. Tiger Woods will be there, hoping to win his 15th major. It's been a long, cold spell for Woods, who last won a major in 2008 at the U.S. Open. Rory McIlroy will be on the course, hoping to avoid repeating an implosion of his game. He led most of last year's tournament, only to fade dramatically at the end. Since then, he's been playing perhaps the best golf of his life. The defending Masters champion is Charles Schwartzel. He'll be there tomorrow along with three-time former champion Phil Mickelson. The Major League Baseball season starts stateside tonight. The season actually started last week in Tokyo, of all places, where the Seattle Mariners beat the Oakland Athletics 3-1. Tonight, the defending world champion Cardinals will play the new-look Marlins in Miami for the first game this season on American soil. There's a full schedule of games tomorrow, and by the way, this year marks the 50th anniversary of Houston having a Major League franchise. The Astros were known as the Colt 45s when they took the field in 1962. This is their final season in the National League. Texas State baseball is tied for 6th in the South in conference standings, headed into a weekend series at A&M Corpus. The Cats have won 4 of their last 5 ball games and are 18-10 overall. Catcher Andrew Stump was named a College Baseball 360 primetime performer.
Coming up next, we'll take a look at a new report on Texas
unemployment rates.
And we'll see how San Marcos is gearing up to celebrate Easter. Stay right here.
The number of bike riders on the Texas State campus is continuously growing. In an effort to ensure the safety of riders, Texas State offers assistance with all your bike needs. The Bike Cave, located in the Colorado Building, can help with repairs to your bike and even has bikes for sale. For more information, head on over to the Bike Cave or visit thebikecave.org.
All right, severe weather pounded North Texas on Tuesday. Forecasters at the National Weather Service say that 6 to 13 tornadoes touched down. Wow. This is a video of a twister hitting Forney just east of Dallas. About 300 buildings were damaged in Lancaster, and more than 110 aircraft at Dallas-Fort Worth International Airport were damaged by hail as the storms moved through. Airlines canceled 400 departures, and more than 3 dozen incoming flights were diverted to other airports because of the storm.
Denver is getting a break from the unusually warm, dry weather it has had lately. The city received some light snow yesterday, which contributed to power being knocked out for more than 20,000 people in the Denver metro area. Some schools canceled classes for the day. Only minor problems were reported on the roadways, with some traffic lights out and slippery roads.
After a long class, it's common for Texas State students to grab a snack. And in this Bobcat update, Roland Garensway tells us about a local favorite called the Mansky Roll. Mansky Rolls are pretty good for breakfast, too.
Gil's Broiler is perhaps the oldest restaurant in San Marcos. Their charbroiled burgers and reasonable prices attract Texas State students as well as San Marcos locals. It's the Mansky Roll, however, that has made the restaurant famous nationwide. Longtime employee John Redden says he isn't surprised to see people from across the country come to Gil's to get their hands on one.
It's not at all uncommon for us to get people from Oregon, people from Kansas, people from California, who come all the way to this town just for the roll. In addition to that, like most students at this university, LBJ was a big fan of the Mansky Roll, so when he became president, he ordered them shipped over to 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
The Mansky Roll, named after creators Roland and Ruth Mansky, is no ordinary cinnamon roll. Redding says the roll is 100% homemade, with no artificial sweeteners or preservatives, and has been made the same way since the 1940s. Texas State alum Cole Patterson says the Mansky Roll is a no-brainer.
Can't really go wrong when you see them, especially when you look behind the counter and you see all these rows and rows and rows of just goodness and tastiness, and they're pretty awesome, yeah.
Just one bite of this Mansky Roll, it's easy to see why this is the oldest snack in San Marcos. For Bobcat Update, I'm Roland Garinsley.
Farmer Fred's Garden Spring Carnival is in town. The carnival will be held at the San Marcos Plaza Park. It's an annual low-cost, family-friendly event where participants can play games, take pictures with the Easter Bunny, and join in an Easter egg hunt. The carnival starts tomorrow at 5 and ends at 9. Admission is free.
Easter Sunday will be observed this weekend. Marina Garcia reports on how several Texas State students plan to celebrate the day.
Easter is the end of the 40-day period known as Lent. Easter is a holy day celebrated by Christians around the world. Minister Jamie Buzar says most churches in the San Marcos area will have a special worship service.
We are planning to have our regularly scheduled worship service on Sunday night at 7 o'clock. But of course, because it's Easter, with all the bells and whistles.
Business management major Adrian Ibarra is going to spend the day with family.
This Easter, I plan to spend time with my mom and that side of the family and just probably we usually go to the park here in San Marcos, and if not, then just hang out and have a big cookout. That's usually what we do.
And he especially enjoys the food they share at Easter.
It's mostly barbecued, you know, throw down like brisket, chicken, probably rice, always rice, and just the basics, you know.
Some students won't be able to go home because the distance is too far to travel, but they fondly remember the holidays of their past.
My brother and I, we would always have Easter baskets. We would wake up on Easter, I guess Easter morning, and see what we got in the basket. And there was always, like, since it's spring going into summer, my mom would always get me a new bathing suit. So she'd get me like a swimsuit and put it in there.
As you can see, this is going to be a fun Easter for everyone around campus. But remember, be careful and eat plenty. For Bobcat Update, I'm Mariana Garcia.
All right, you got any big plans?
This weekend I'm going to play some team handball, enjoy the family, and just see where the weekend takes me.
Yeah, I saw in the newspaper you're looking at the Olympics is looking at you. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it's exciting.
It's pretty great.
Yeah, what are you doing this weekend?
I'm actually going to go see Tosh.0 or Daniel Tosh, a stand-up comedian guy. So, yeah.
Very nice. Thank you for watching. I'm Marilyn Elder.
And I'm Jeff Gorman. Tune in tomorrow for another edition of Bobcat Update.
Have a great day.